Hi, we're the two dudes.
From the Two Dudes Drinking Podcast.
That's Sean.
That's Luke.
And this is episode
73. Boom, boom, part two.
Enjoy.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four. Two dudes drinking. They drink a lot of beer. Game on.
Calling him on the telephone, but he didn't answer. So I left a message saying, "Well, you dirty sack of shit, you were supposed to cut my grass." But it turned out he died of a heart attack while on the toilet. Anyway.
Welcome to Two Dudes Drinking.
A comedy podcast about...
Part two of Sean Makes the Boom Boom. Part one should be Sean Makes the Boom. Part two should be Sean Makes the Boom Boom. Nah, but...
yeah.
Sorry, I'm eating a pizza, so enjoy my chewing.
Oh, I will.
You may recall the last time we left off,
Sean made a boom boom.
Sean pooped himself. I had I blew a fuse and stuttered. And then we had a giggly laughing fit, like, yeah. It's good. But we were going to do our top five something.
Guilty pleasure
songs.
Part two.
Part two.
Yes.
Top five guilty pleasure songs. Part two. Is it still playing? I forgot to put my headphones on. Did it play the first one?
No.
Top five drug musings.
Man, we haven't done a druggy thing in a long time.
We haven't podcasted in a long time.
That's true.
Dos for Daniel.
Dos for Daniel. Dos for Daniel.
You guys are going to hear all this. This is a pizza. Just kidding, it's porn.
Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, I know.
Oh.
Oh, so anyway, the Jungle Book. Christopher Walken is King Louie, and Bill Murray as Baloo. Couldn't save that. The way they sang a
Bill
song
Murray,
was shit.
I can see it. There's Christopher... What's King Louie?
He's the orangutan, King of the Apes.
Right.
Well, I'm the king of the swingers. Oh, the jungle will be happy.
I'm the king of...
It's not you. I want to be like you.
Sorry, this chewing is very professional.
Yeah,
it wasn't great. Let's keep this respectful. We don't want to get a hashtag Me Too against two dudes drinking here.
Why? We're talking about dudes.
Have we talked about Lupita Nyong'o? Nyong'o?
Who?
I don't know if we had. She's in Black Panther. Nice looking lady.
Yeah. So's, what's her name? Dana Guerrera?
What?
The Michonne from Walking Dead.
Was that her?
Yeah, she's in that.
Motherfucker. I never put that together.
Huh.
That's her?
Yeah, that's her.
Son of a bitch. That character's awesome. Yeah, seriously, that character's fucking great.
Oh, good.
I feel really
good. She's a good actress. The Walking Dead is shit now. But we're not going to go down that road again.
Who's got that Black Panther money now? Does this sound good?
Oh, that means they're going to kill her off, too.
Yeah.
We can't afford her anymore. Fucking goddamn Scott Gimple.
This is more of a Walking Dead movie, not a Black Panther movie.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
As per usual, we'll play a little snippet.
My honorable one? Well, I have eight, actually.
That's fine.
But it was going to be Redbone, Come and Get Your Love, but then Guardians of the Galaxy kind of blew that song up, so yeah. Everybody likes it now.
Funny thing, Sean legit we were just having a regular conversation, and you were just like, I just fucking love this song. I forget how it even came up.
Yeah, I can't remember either.
But I thought you were kidding. You're like, no, I really like this.
It's a good song. I mean, should I play a little bit?
A couple seconds.
Let's see.
Did you have it queued up?
I was actually playing something else. So.
You missed a chance.
Oh, wait. No, hold on. Isn't that great?
Native Americans?
Yeah. Oh, this is a great fucking song. Yeah. Okay. Next.
First on my Listeroony Dooney. Sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm not sorry. Nah.
Is that, so I just had to switch from Wi-Fi to not Wi-Fi, so that song,
is your shit fucking up too?
No, it's my, my Wi-Fi is fucking up right now.
See, mine too. I don't get it.
Do you have Spectrum?
Yep.
Oh,
dude. You have to reset everything.
That's because they fucking suck.
Every fucking day I have to at least restart my phone or something.
You should put this on the rant episode. Yeah. There's places, it's fucking North Carolina or something, or whatever.
How does rant mean?
But places where Google Fibers come in, and apparently it's amazing, and it has good customer service, but they're building it slow, so it's not everywhere. Uh-huh. Apparently, like, all of a sudden in these towns, without changing anything, Time Warner / Spectrum is all of a sudden, and, what's the other one? Comcast. They're just like, oh, we have this new package. Oh, look how cheap it is. And you get all this. And it's like, you didn't do anything. You were just fucking gouging.
Oh, no. They upped our shit. And they said, oh, that was an introductory rate. Yep. We've had the same shit for fucking years.
They pull the same bullshit.
Anyway. Motherfuckers.
First on my list is that song that goes, don't you want me, baby? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I really like this song. What's that? There was a movie where Marissa Tomei and John C. Reilly's characters sang it to each other. Probably makes me like it a little more.
Oh, she's adorable.
Aunt May?
Huh?
Aunt May? The new Aunt May.
Oh, okay, yeah.
She'll be on the list soon.
Don't you want me?
Ready? That's all you get.
Nice. How many do you have? Did you stick with five?
I stuck with five.
Okay.
I stick five.
Let's see.
Sorry if that's automatically placed.
That's fine. I'm probably going to drop off some as we go.
Sorry. Queuing up.
My next one is this song.
Fuck you, I love that song.
What do you mean, fuck me? I like it too, that's why I'm playing it.
No, it's not a guilty pleasure. Dude, I love No Doubt. Like, unapologetically.
I mean, not so much, just like a couple.
Yeah. Oh, you ever want a fun riff to play?
This was back when she was still hot.
I'm Just a Girl riff. I used to know how to play it. Dude, that guy can fucking play.
Oh, he's a great guitarist.
Tommy on the home right now, ducking on the spider webs.
Did I skip it? Yeah, here we go.
Here we go.
Tommy on the home right now, ducking on the spider webs. Leave a message and I'll call you back. Call you back. It's all your fault. In my portal. My balls my porn balls.
Okay.
Anyway.
God damn, it's a good song. We can't sing along to this next one because you don't know it.
How do you know I don't know it?
I will give you $50 if you can tell me the lyrics to this song.
Okay.
No way, you can Google it. Fuck you.
There's no lyrics in there. It's fucking instrumental, isn't it?
No. There's a couple lyrics. Anyway, it's a song from Final Fantasy. I was playing Final Fantasy 13 years ago.
Mm.
The game was okay, but like there's this one section, and this song just fucking stuck in my head, and I loved it. It's a fucking nerdy video game song.
Nice.
Goes a little something like this. It's all techno, and it gets all like Japanesey. These games have great music,
but yeah, then there's that is easy Japanesey.
This part I really like. This lady starts singing, and she's Japanese, so she doesn't pronounce it right, which I find endearing. Powerful. Yep. A bit of a guilty pleasure. Really like this song.
Oh, you're fucking weird.
Listen to harp. Oh, shit. Hold on. Damn it. I missed the harp solo. Bear with me. Bears. Okay. Harp. I'm going to air harp. Ready? Ready? Yeah. And I still missed the cue.
Yep.
Anyway.
Have you started watching Ash vs. the Evil Dead yet?
No, but it's on Netflix, so I can finally catch up.
The new season
Sorry, I've
started?
Been playing a lot of video games lately.
Oh, dude. You'll see what happens with the harp.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay.
Go on.
Here's my next one. Red Red Wine by, I believe it's pronounced UB40? I don't know.
It's pronounced up 40. That wasn't very good.
But just a great song. Good background music for all you.
UB40 is one of those bands that I know a lot of people listen to.
Hmm.
And I can't tell you a single song, so now I know.
Yeah. And knowing is half the battle.
UB40!
Anyway.
Ah, I wish I would have thought of that.
Anyway, Red, red wine, you make me feel so fine. Go on.
I almost feel like this song's been on one of my lists before.
Go on.
But I could be wrong. It's called Les Artistes? Les Artistes? Something? From a lady called...
Hey, Lay Your Titties.
From a lady called Santigold.
Santa Claus?
Yep.
Santa?
And of all things, I discovered this song on a, Wow, that's loud.
Mm-hmm.
I like the way her voice sounds. But it was on a hockey game.
The way she sings reminds me of, like, Sting when he was in the Police.
And it's got that weird plucky guitar, too.
Yeah.
I get to the chorus.
But, yeah, it's not bad. Oh, man. I thought it was.
I just fucking love this chorus, too. This is a good song.
It kind of sounds like a new age, like if the Police came out now.
I can see that.
Yeah. I'll go. Fuck, Police is a great band. I
fucking love the album cover.
What the fuck?
It's just a picture of her with her mouth open, and then they put glitter over top of it to make it look like she's throwing up glitter.
Oh, nice.
See, and another thing, you know, I can't explain it. After that came out, that type of music kind of blew up for about a year.
Mm-hmm.
That, like, pop, indie, but, like, kind of, sort of, electronic. I have nothing against it. It was pretty good.
Yeah.
But then that music kind of went away. But I kind of wish it would come back because it was decent.
Yeah.
Understandable. Sorry. Anyway, Santigold.
All my shit's all fucking old.
That's okay.
My next one is this one.
The Tide Isn't that the song you by, just played?
By Blondie. Is it? It is similar, yes. I don't know why. I mean, that could be why.
Is this the one that goes, I wanna be?
Yeah.
I never knew it was called The Tide Is High.
There you go. Something about it, man.
So it's Blondie and not Debbie Harry?
Yeah, just Blondie.
Dude, that band fucking ran that. You know, they were like in the punk scene and then they branched out to this shit?
Weird, right?
It is, but at the same time, you're like, can you imagine if Lumberjack starts releasing, like, all right, this is going to be a smooth reggae song about love? People will be like, fuck you, Skylar. Sing songs about pooping.
Okay.
Okay. I want to take a number two. Damn it. Both were good.
Real quick. You know their song, Heart of Glass?
Yeah.
That's the one. What's weird is, like, my parents, you know, had a collection of vinyl when we were growing up. We had that album, and on the corner, the top corner, it said Terry. It was my dad's. Which is like, what the fuck? You know, looking back, we'd have to ask him about
you
that.
You think Big T can't relate to a heart of glass?
Oh, you know. I mean, oh, man. I gotta get him drunk to do karaoke of that song.
And that would sound a little something like...
No, I'm not gonna do it. He may be 58, but he can still kick my ass.
Hello, Mr. Anders.
Ew.
Yeah, that sounded fucking weird. Sorry, sorry. Sorry, everyone. Next on my list is...
It's Anders?
Yeah. Oh. Well, don't go saying his name.
I thought he was the Colonel.
Colonel Anders?
Sanders.
Oh.
I'm kidding. I knew it was Anders.
I like Colonel Anders. Colonel.
Colonel. Colonel.
This one, Colin. I know you're going to be like... You're going to think less of me. Because
That's not possible.
My next two selections are...
Nothing?
I'm just going to ignore that. Words hurt, Sean.
Words are like bullets.
My next two songs are British selections.
Uh-huh.
This one's by a British garage rapper named The Streets.
I think you've played it for me before.
Yeah, probably. It's pretty terrible, but I love it. And this is probably my favorite song by him. It's called Fit But You Know It.
It's jumpy. Excuse me, girl.
Talks to the girl.
I know it's a bit embarrassing, but I just know it's...
Because, you know, songs that have talking are always good.
Excuse me,
bud. I reckon you're about an 8 or a 9. Maybe even 9.5 in 4 beers time. That blue top shop top you've got on is nice. Bit too much fake tan, no, but yeah, you score high. But there's just one little thing that's
our filler
episode.
Yeah, that's rapping.
Just know it. I'm not trying
to pull you. Not that I'm talking shit.
I would like to. I reckon you're about an 8 or a 9.
So when I looked at you standing right there with your hoard, I was waiting in the queue looking at the board.
I like this part because he goes,
wondering whether to have a burger or chips or what the shrapnel in my back pocket could afford.
Sorry.
When I noticed out the corner of my eye, looking toward my direction, your eyes locked on my course.
Sorry.
I couldn't concentrate on what I wanted to order, which lost me my place in the queue I waited for. Yeah.
There's a fucking part on there where this girl I used to work with, it was where he starts like yelling at the character.
Uh-huh.
And his like hype man He's like, and he's, you know, it's like, whoa, whoa, whoa. But he goes, oi, oi, oi. The girl I work with, it would be dead silent. And she'd just all of a sudden go like, oi, oi, oi. Like, what the fuck? Jessica, you don't listen. But if you do, hi.
Yeah. She doesn't listen.
She doesn't listen. Man, was that number four? Twas.
Yeah.
Yeah, you go ahead with, I mean, would this be your last one? If you got two more, that's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
You do one, I'll do one.
I chopped off a couple because, you know, I don't want to.
It's all for fun. Yeah. Hi, Yogi.
Wow. Well, I've been listening to a lot of, like, 90s stuff here recently. And
Spice Girls and such.
Oh, God, no. I can't even do that. Where is it at? Where is it at? Give me one second.
Give me all your loving, all your hugs and kisses, too.
Is it kisses? Oh. I was made for loving you?
Yeah, no. I don't care. It's a good song. Mr. Jones, man. Counting Crows, motherfucker.
Jacket keeps on getting. Of course. We just skip to the good part. The end.
God damn it.
Yeah.
What the fuck? I think I passed it.
Not even gonna sing along.
Nope.
Yes, you're a Jones on me.
Can't do that.
Jones.
Sorry, they do it backwards so I can go, or inhaling so I can do it higher.
That's a Tenacious D song.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
Inward singing.
Yeah. You've played it for me before.
It's newest thing in singing technology.
I've also been watching a lot of the IT Crowd again.
I just finished going through it again myself.
Oh, what a great fucking show.
Memory is RAM.
Dude, that show's so fucking good.
Anyway, go ahead.
Going to put my new next on my list on here, but I don't think you want to listen to Cradle of Filth.
It's crazy that guy's old Greg.
Old Greg, I never watched that. I think I do a pretty good Richmond.
I've got the funk. Funky ball of tits from
outer
space.
Aren't you going to be Roy?
Hold on. Fuck, I can't remember.
It was then that I discovered Sean could not do the Roy voice.
You guys couldn't see it. I did the Richmond pose if you watch IT Crowd.
I like the episode where they're the dinner party. And like at the end of it, like they got the music blaring and Jen walks out and, why is this so loud? And turns it down. They're like, no. And then you just hear them fucking in the back. Like, and that lady just goes, oh, look at me. I'm having an orgasm.
Having an orgasm. We're talking. That's such a good fucking show. It's a good episode.
This morning I watched the one where she had a handyman.
Oh, Jesus. It's got anyway, the cameras and shit.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
But 80% sure. I can't do this.
50-50. Hello, I can't either.
Hello, IT. Have you tried turning it on and off again?
Almost. Go home and practice. Yeah. Come back.
Yeah, come back.
Moss is easy. You just go nasally and you go, hello, Jen.
Hello, Jen.
I've got a concussion.
It's a fucking one with the lady's trousers.
Oh, dude, that was good. Is that the same one where she's like, I still have the internet?
Yes. And then it's like, we're not doing that anymore. Aw. Goddamn. Message of the day. If you haven't seen the IT Crowd,
yes.
Go watch the fucking IT Crowd.
Go watch it before they try to bring it over here again and butcher it.
Oh, they are.
Yeah, I know.
Again, I know. Their third try or something.
Joel McHale. What the fuck?
I like Joel McHale.
Yeah, but it doesn't fit.
Oh, hey, let's do banter written for an Irish guy from Joel McHale. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Why don't they just get the original fucking cast, bring it here, and make new episodes? Done.
The one where they did their like YouTube channel.
Oh god, that's Charles's one.
No, the one.
You talk about the one with the games, board
yeah.
games. Yeah, that's the same one.
Was it?
Because
oh, it was like a 2-part episode. That like it was long.
Yeah. Well, that wasn't that season
the explosions
five?
And shit. I can't remember.
Yeah, because the first one they showed was they were all boring, but the second one they're all wearing ladies' slacks.
Do you realize this whole episode is just. Let's crowd. Just talk about the IT yeah. crowd.
Well, go ahead and do your next one.
No, I want to keep talking about the IT crowd. It is also British, much like my last person here.
Uh-huh.
What else happened in IT crowd? Wait, hold on. What else happened? I lost it.
What else happened in IT crowd?
What else happened in the IT crowd?
I like when he stares off and everybody just kind of looking behind him like, huh?
Just don't open that door.
I want to know what's behind that door. Those motherfuckers. I like it. I like
damn these electric sex pens.
I don't know which boss I like better.
I like that. I like young Random better.
Like, because old Random was so like, dry, but still.
Which,
but dude, when he jumped out the window.
Spoiler alert!
Fuck him,
dude. That death
was an old show
because he's so like straight up. And yeah. What was it?
There are dangers out here.
You guys don't know what we're talking about, but it's a fucking funny show.
Or when he's trapped under the desk, Roy's trapped under the desk, and when Jen goes up there, oh, Mark has taken off his shirt. And they go look, and it's just this out of shape, fucking pale white guy. He just crawls up from under. Oh, man.
The one where she dates the keyboardist.
He's I don't remember.
And they're like, you're just dating him because he's in a band.
Oh,
he's
yes,
got
yes.
huge glasses and these weird fucking, like, slack jawed look.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. Gay, a gay musical.
Oh, God.
It is delightful.
It's gay. Oh, that's got the best line.
I'm disabled. Disabled.
What kind of disabled?
Leg disabled.
Dude, the whole reveal at the end, spoiler, when fucking Moss is behind the counter.
What can I get you, man?
Yes, coming up. That's a great fucking episode. Yes. Willies. We love Willies.
The whole one, like, ah, oh, fuck. Was it, they're all singing that in the bus.
That's what I'm talking about.
I know. Oh, man.
Jesus, that is a good show. And the amount of times they go, Jesus Christ! It's just not. See, the British don't put, like, they don't care about words, because they're just words, but the IT crowd does it, like, they say fuck, like, what, twice?
Yeah.
But they place it so well that you're just like, yeah, it's funny.
No, dude, the episode where, young Random finds the gun, and his father left him a note.
Oh, look, a gun!
As you know, I jumped out the window. But when Moss is going up to the bull, he said, I have a gun!
Oh, I've got a ready gun!
Hold on, one more and then we'll move on. Okay, when they put the sexual harassment pants on young Random, and Moss has got the concussion and he's trying to help him fix the pants, and they're doing a tour, and he's got his pants down and Moss is working on him, but he's in front of him and looks like he's blowing him. And the tour walks in, and there's Random with his hands on his hips, and Moss just, like, leans his head over, and he's just like, looks at the tour group, he's like, fuck off! Like, wait, he probably says, fuck off! Like, oh, it's a good show.
Is it Moss or Roy?
That was Moss.
Oh.
Did I say Roy?
No, you said Moss, but you sounded like Roy when you did it.
No, the guy who says it was Random.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know what I'm doing when I get home.
Jerking it?
Well, yeah. That's a given.
Thinking about
Moss.
I was going to say the. Damn it. What's her last name?
Back to the gay episode. Oh, you Irish. I'm tired. I'm going to get a wheelchair. And he dumps that dude out.
What's Jen's character's last name?
I don't know.
Oh, IMDb. God, I can't remember. I know the actress's name is Catherine Parkinson.
What?
That's her name.
Parkinson.
Jen.
Oh, God damn it.
I don't remember it. Exciting stuff. Hurry.
The IT crowd. Barber. Duh.
Oh, right.
Jen Barber.
Right. Anyway, that's what you're Googling later.
When they,
God damn it.
No, when the episode where Runham kills himself and Moss fixes Roy's phone. Turn it up to 8 or whatever. It might blow my cock off. A great man has died. Who else died?
Move on.
Oh shit, what's your last one?
Wait. Father! Anyway.
Oh shit. I lost the headphones. What the fuck?
There we go.
My fault.
All right. Next anyway. On my list is a nice little song by Lily Allen.
Oh wait. Have you seen this other show?
Who?
Richard Iowati?
Iowati.
Iowati?
Richard Iowati. Which one?
The one where he's like traveling with people. It's on Hulu. I can't remember what.
No. Fucking email that to me. Not now. Later. I'll write a note.
It's right here. It should be. Ah, fuck it. Yeah, I'll let you know.
I wrote a note.
What's your
I have a soft spot for Lily Allen. She's a British pop singer.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
She writes kind of quirky songs, and she says the F word in pop songs, and it makes it nice. Anyway, she's like a raunchy Katy Perry. But anyway, here's the first song I heard from her. And this song is about her brother, his name is Alfie Allen. And some of you may recognize that as the gentleman from...
it's called Travel Man.
Travel Man.
48 hours and something. Okay, go on. Sorry about that. Carry on.
He is in Game of Thrones. He plays... God, I need more sleep. I can't think of it. Theon Greyjoy. Or Reek. Reek rhymes with meek. You just gotta...
You said Theon?
Theon Greyjoy.
Theon Greyjoy.
Theon
Huxtable.
I want you to betray that family. Spoiler alert.
We're still waiting for the dragons to show home.
Yep, we're gonna return court to the Ironborn as what is dead may never die. That's from the show.
I've never seen it, but it's still funny.
Yeah. Anyway, this song's about her brother.
Neat.
It's quirky. I like it. It's coming. There we go.
Look at that.
My little brother's in his bedroom smoking weed. I tell him he should get up.
That's delightful.
Right?
Yeah.
Her other shit's pretty good, too. Listen to it. Isn't it great? It makes you like...
I mean, I'm not meaning this sarcastically, but it's very pleasing.
Yes.
Can't happen.
I think Sean's going to Spotify later.
It's good. Text me her name. So I'll fucking forget.
She calls him a twat later in the song.
Nice.
All right, I can unplug my phone now.
Okay. Are you ready? Oh, God. Oh, God.
What you are next to?
Oh, fucking bad. Anyway. Here we go.
Do it in the top 5 list tonight. Get a fucking dude. Yeah. Just like his huge dick.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual.
You know what I like in this song?
Where it goes. Like a horse.
But when I see you hanging about with anyone,
yeah, that's about his dick and ball.
It's not unusual.
He's talking to it.
See me cry.
I'm doing a ball dance. You can't see it. Oh wait, it's Tom Jones. So I got to go out at any time. Poor Elvira.
I fucked it up.
Well, it's only us that can't hear it.
Yeah, I know. How am I going to make fun of it? I can't hear it.
It's not unusual. It happens every day. No matter what you say, you'll find it happens all the time.
Yeah. Hey, here's a whistle. Sorry, I just really like this song.
I mean, we've probably been sued now. We don't have any money, so Tom Jones is just going to fuck you.
Ah, fuck.
It's okay, you've had fitters before. Only this one's like your whole body.
Yeah, it's just going to split me in two.
It's not unusual.
Okay, let's probably stop that.
Well, it'll work out, because like, if you don't feel like going to record, I'd be like, all right, other butt cheek, you go record today. I could do better. all I got. Anything else?
Let's see. We did the top five. What else was there?
Oh, I have two ladies.
Oh, yes. I
over 60. I was just watching TV and... both coincidentally came across the screen, and I was like, man, those are some, attractive older ladies.
No. Well, you don't like L7?
Saw them live once. They opened for Merlin Manson.
Yeah.
In 1997.
I just wanted to be a dick for a second. Anyway, go on.
First one, Tanya Roberts. You will know her as Donna's mom, Mrs. Penciotti.
Really? How old is she?
Oh, she was 60 something. I don't remember.
if only.
Hang on. I mean, come on. Everybody like.
Yeah.
I mean, when you weren't looking at Bob.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, here, hold here. Midge? Was that her name?
Yeah, it was Midge.
Hey, you and Midge.
You can...
Roberts?
Tanya Roberts. T-A-N-Y? From That 70s Show. And more. She was a Bond girl, I think?
Go on.
Next on my list... Also, a TV mom.
Go on.
In that very same show, Deborah Jo Rupp.
Is that Kitty?
Kitty Foreman.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
I don't know what it is. She,
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Sorry, I'm... Are you looking at pictures of Tanya Roberts?
Yeah.
Jesus, you pervert.
62.
Yeah. I think Deborah Jo Rupp is 66.
Yeah, I don't know.
And hey, Red Foreman's also in his 60s. Dumbass.
Isn't he 70 now?
Probably. He's still.
Let's see. What'd you say? Deborah Jo Rupp?
Deborah Jo Rupp.
67, yeah. Jesus Christ.
But she's aged well. Yeah. She's funny.
Her role on Friends was creepy as shit. I don't know why, it just was.
Because she was dating an 18-year-old.
Yeah, probably.
You ever think, like, do that show now and switch roles? Like, if it was Phoebe's younger sister?
He is 74.
Wow.
Anyway, go on.
Wow. Yeah, sorry, I channeled some Owen Wilson there.
Wow.
Anyway, go on. but if that role was reversed, and if Phoebe's 18-year-old sister... was dating a 46-year-old dude.
Yeah.
That shit would not fly these days.
Nope.
Hey. Yeah, it's okay for men to be victimized, but...
Yeah, well, you know.
I mean, come on, Deborah Jo Rupp, though.
Yeah, yeah.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, she's a very attractive lady.
Yep. That's all I have.
Let's see. Was there anything else? I feel
did,
like we're...
Did you ever figure out what ramp means?
No.
How many times do you think we've said that joke?
Probably a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fuck.
We said a joke.
I think that's it.
All right. Well.
Unless you want to throw in another... Another top five.
We got shit to do.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
We should totally get flying hellfish tattoos.
Oh, I would totally fucking do that. Yeah. It's okay because they're like a fake group, right?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
I got a buddy that's apprenticing right now.
Really?
Yep.
So, is he looking for guinea pigs?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Call him. Let's go right now. Fuck it.
We got work to do.
Yeah, fine.
Oh, he works a second job, too.
Ah.
Because, you know, apprenticing for free and all.
Yeah.
If you're in...
I'd totally love to get one.
I don't know if he's done collar yet, but... Fuck it. Yeah. Right on my neck.
What's that? Wrinkly gibberish?
All right. I got nothing else.
I think it's it.
All right. For two dudes drinking, I am Luke.
And I am Sean.
And you're Morgan Freeman.
And I'm Morgan Freeman.
And I'm Andy Dufresne.
Is that what he sounds like?
Fuck, hold on. There's an island called Zihuatanejo. I can't do it.
And I'm Richmond.
And I'm Jen.
Hello, I tell you.
Nice.
It's not great, but it's...
Hello. Hello, Sean.
Hello, Luke.
It's me, Moss, from the podcast. We work together.
Oh, man.
Sorry, he's concussed.
God damn, that's a good fucking show.
And I'm Phil Anselmo.
This is a podcastiest podcast. You know, podcast.
I want these guys to just, you know, split open the ground and, you know, try to jump in. It's just too much. Don't underestimate the kid. Fucking crazy if you do.
Hey, Luke, what's your penis doing?
Penis be throbbing. My penis be throbbing. Yeah. Of all throbs, he's of all throbs. Nobody throbs like us.
My penis! Penis throbbing! Wow! Throbbing my cock! Throbbing my...
That's awesome.
Oh, I'm going to get beat to death when this drops.
Yep.
Bye!
Bye! Hey, thanks for watching.
Be sure to like and subscribe.
Mm-hmm.